Yes. Hi. Hi.
It's good to see you.
Yes. I'm not wonderful, but it's better. Then you hear me better. And if I move and make the draping, it's perfect.
Well, you look good.
The draping is you go on the dress form and you take a fabric and you create directly on the dress form your clothes. And it's really nice because you see immediately three dimension, because if you make flat patterns, it's two dimensional. And draping is immediately three dimension. And you see the proportions and the silhouettes, and it's really interesting because when you start, for instance, if you're flaring a skirt, you see immediately, oh, did I flare enough? Shall I flare more? And this is interesting. It's an technique, it's not so familiar. Yes, the most people, they learn the pattern making, but draping not. It's like, yes, the higher level of creating garments. But yes, and the combination is perfect also. If you know pattern making, you can do the basics and then change it on the dress form. And you know, like you will see, I change then the camera and we go to my dress form. Even if you don't have a dress form, you can do it, you know, or on a hanger, sure. And the dress form, it's perfect, yes. But if you want to, today, what we're doing, the t-shirt, you can do it on a hanger, you can do it on a person. And sure, when you're pinning, you have to be careful not to pin the person.
Sorry about that.
Otherwise, yes, can be a little bit hard. But otherwise, you can also find other techniques. Sure, if you create a basic bodice and you have to do everything on the dress form, it's difficult. But if you have to change garments, like I'm going to show you today, you can really do on a person or on a hanger.
I'm so excited about this. I actually chose this shirt specifically because I altered it myself. It was a normal long sleeve hoodie, and I would never choose to wear it because I didn't like the sleeves very much. And right before I went to throw it away, I was like, hey, let's try something. What if I cut the sleeves? How do I feel about it then? Now it's one of my very favorite hoodies.
Great. This is great because I'm also saying then the planet will be happy. Yes,
yes, exactly.
Instead of throwing away, you can start. I suggest always to try it, and then you are always in time to throw it away. But it was also fun, no? To cut it and see, then to see, okay, perhaps next time you are going to add some other fabrics, yes? Or you are changing the neckline or the length or whatever.
Yeah, absolutely. Actually, it was probably like 2 years ago that I tried to upcycle for the first time. And ever since then, anytime I'm like, yeah, I'm not really liking this t-shirt, these pants, whatever, before I decide to donate or throw it away, because I know a lot of donations don't actually make it anywhere. They also go to the dump. And so I always try and alter it and see if I like it better. And you're right, I like to add fabrics. I actually brought a couple patterns of like way crazy fabrics that I like to throw on to those, just to mix them up. I have,
yes,
like,
this is colorful. You give a lot of colors.
Yes, loads of colors. And we actually have some shorts in the basket that we want to try and repurpose the back pattern. So it's loads of fun.
You can do a lot, yes.
Tons. And even just something simple like cutting your sleeves off. Now it's one of my favorite hoodies and I almost threw it away.
Yes, exactly, exactly. And it makes it much younger, perhaps. Perhaps they were, I don't know, the length was not the right length, or they were too tight. Cutting, it becomes something new.
Something completely new. And that's why I'm so excited to be joining with you today to show, you know, everyone watching some tips and tricks on how to alter their own clothes, because even the simplest change can make the biggest difference.
Look here. This is now a t-shirt I want to change. The first thing, I'm going to change the neckline, yes? I'm going to take, this is called a styling tape, yes? Here, what is important, that it's quite thin. I would say this is like, it's like 4 or 5 millimeters. I would say it's a little bit less than a quarter of an inch, yes? Because what is important, that you can create curves, yes? Because if it's too stiff, you can't get curves. Yeah. And now I'm marking only half of it, yes? I am creating a new line. Yes, that means here I am creating a bigger neckline. Mark it all around. You see here?
Yeah, it seems so much easier actually to do draping, to be able to see how you're changing your shirt.
You see, for instance here, you see immediately, you say, good, I mark this, but how would it look like with a V-neck, yes? I could also say, perhaps it would be nicer with a V-neck, yes? And you change it and you see it immediately, yes? That means I could change it still. Or I don't know, you can have here a little bit like a little bit squared. Yes, I want to have it a little bit like squared, whatever you want.
Yeah.
That means now I marked quite quick here my neckline. Yes, I'm going to show you, but perhaps I wanted to show you another thing, how to change also your sleeves, for instance. Look here, these are the basic sleeves. Mm-hmm. And I want to make it a little bit more feminine, a little bit more, I don't know, smaller also the sleeves. That means I want to make cap sleeves, yes? That means also here I take my black, in this case it's white styling tape, and I am pinning my new sleeves, yes? I'm getting the new shape thing here.
Perfect thing, I feel like the biggest thing that bugs me about shirts in the end is their necklines and how long their sleeves are. I'm like, I need a shorter sleeve.
No, I have to say, I think also in the end, the biggest thing you can change is the neckline, because sometimes a boring neck, if you only make a big, nice neckline, it's done, yes? But also sleeves. We learned also changing the sleeves change a lot, yes? That means
Yeah, we have a little stack of clothes, so we'll have to send you some photos of what we do to them.
Yes, what you have done, please. I have
we have so many.
If you learned a lot, if you were good students. I can see now, it looks sure, but is it the right line I would like? Yes, if you open it, it would look like this. Yeah. And this I'm going now to take down, because I am changing it. I show you then how to cut it. I go shoulder on shoulder, yes, and finding my center front, yes. That means here in the center, I put a pin, yes. And the same thing I do also on the back, yes. That means also here, shoulder on shoulder, and I mark the center back in order that I can mark exactly my neckline and I make it symmetric. Yes, because you see here, can you see this?
Yeah.
I am drawing here now my neckline. Yes, that means here I am connecting my lines. I go to the back. Here is my center, and also here I'm connecting my lines.
This gets me excited, Alter. Yeah, we've talked about it for so long.
What is going to happen? And now I am going to cut exactly here in the center. Yes, that means I have here my line. I cut in my center, in the center front. And then the same thing I'm doing in the center back, because I'm going to cut away halfway, yes? That means one side, and then I'm copying it to the other side. Then I'm sure I have exactly the same on both sides, yes? I make it now quite quick, because otherwise you will be bored. I'm working too slow, yes? Mm-hmm. This is now the halfway, and now I'm going to copy it exactly to the other sides in order to have exactly the same on both sides. Yes, that means I am putting now shoulder on shoulder. Here you're 100% sure it has to be, it's now the same. Even sure, you have to be a little bit precise, you can't go too quick, yes? But otherwise you get really a nice symmetric neckline in this case, yes? I copied it. Now I can take it away.
What are the tools and devices you would recommend that if someone wants to start altering their clothes on a regular basis, they should have these tools in their kit?
I would say what is important is the measuring tape. Yes, the measuring tape is important. Then a chalk or also a pencil. Then sure, the pins. Here I have the styling tape I talked about before. Then fabric scissors. And then I have two rulers, especially. One is this straight ruler, and then the other one is this curve, which is, it's called the hip curve. Yes, I think these are the most important things you need, yes, which I'm using every time. Then I have some extra things, but with this already, you can do a lot. And then sure, a sewing needle, or a sewing machine if you want them to sew, yes? But for instance, what I'm doing here, there's nothing to sew, yes? It's only cutting. But now I have done this. And the only thing, you know what I've done? Now being quick, I cut into my t-shirt a little bit. I have done something you should never do. See what I've done? My God. Because I did it quick and but you get the idea. Don't make the mistakes like I am doing. I mark again here outside of my styling tape. Yes, that means here. It's the same. You can put it on top or below. Yes, what is important, you follow or you stay on top or you go below. Mm. And then you will see. And at a certain point, you finish in your armhole, yes? It depends where on your design. I finish here, yes? Here is my armhole, do you see it? Mm-hmm. It means here it's finishing. Then I go to my other side. For instance, here I see it's a little bit too curved. I don't like this so much. I change this a little bit. Yes, and now I'm marking here.
And are you gonna do the same thing with the cut? So once you cut this off, pin it to the other side, re-chalk it, and then make the cut?
Yes, exactly. And here you have to be careful. I tell you this then perhaps we don't finish it totally for the time. But here it's really important to write yourself. Yes, you see when I cut this away, then here I write its back part, yes? This is the back, yes? Mm-hmm. And this is front because they are not the same, yes? And I have to give then front on front and back on back, yes? Because otherwise you are making two left sleeves or two right sleeves, yes? Now I'm going to open, see here, I open on my seam, under the armhole. And now I'm cutting exactly on my armhole. Till I come to my line, and now I am cutting on my line. Till I come again to my armhole. Yes, that means here. Showed you now on the dress form then, but you see here only how it looks. Totally different. And this is my sleeve, yes? This is my sleeve I cut away. And to understand how to put this then, perhaps I'm not doing it, but everybody will understand it. It's important. Here I'm on the front, yes? That you find front, yes? This is the front. That means in this case, you put nice side on nice side. Front on front. And then you pin it and you get again exactly your line.
Ah, so yes. It's inside out this time in order to match.
Exactly, but what is important, if you put it the wrong side, you make it the opposite. Therefore, well, it's important to write yourself. You can make an X or you write front and back, whatever. But in this case, it would be nice side on nice side and your mark. Now I show you on the dress form. I wanted to have this. Look here. This is something interesting. And here, look how the back is looking. Yes. Here's the back. Looking
nice.
See the difference like between here and having here this cap sleeves. For instance, what you can do, what is nice with an elastic, you could put, for instance, if you don't want to cut it away, but for you could put elastic and you get here gathered. It could be also really nice. Yes, you gather.
Nice.
And okay. Change it. You could also have the gathering here on the side, yes, for instance. Or what you, it would also nice when you both sleeves you make shorter, you can put something also here and here. Now this is, it would be much nicer with a jersey, yes, if you cut here like a belt. Yes, this is, you would get, now here I have still the sleeves long, but if you have them, you cut like this, you can have different ways here. Yes, these are all small things. Sometimes you can create, now this is a little bit hard here, yes, mm-hmm. You can do it in front or here in the side. You can do a sort of, you know, draping. I take with an elastic band, I make like this, and then with a stitch by hand, and you have like a draping. This is already some things you can do. Yes, that means,
yeah, a lot of easy things. Elastics, adding ties, cutting off the shoulders, changing the neckline, or cutting the sleeves. I mean, those are a lot of options to switch up just a simple shirt.
Totally.
Have you seen in the end, I have done this in 15 minutes. Yeah. And therefore you can really do a lot. This evening I'm going out. Today it's hot. I have to open something. You can cut out. Yes, there are hundreds at the shoulder, make a cut out. Yes, therefore here there is open for your fantasy. Be your designer. Yes,
be your own designer.
Anything you can imagine, you can do.
You can also copy. You see, you can take the measurement. If you like this, you take your measurement, the distance, and then you say, okay, also here I make it. Yes, and also how deep shall I go? Yes, therefore you can go wherever you want, and with this styling tape you can get really nice lines. You mark it and copy to the other side, and then you're sure it's symmetric.
Yes, that's I think our biggest takeaway today is copying what you've done on one side to the other side so you can have a symmetry. Totally. I definitely have a weakness there, and I really appreciate you showing that to us today, because it's going to make a world of difference on all the alterations I do. So thank you so much, Sophie, for your time. I really appreciate
you. Thank you.
It was great with you. I'm happy. And yes, I'm happy if everybody is changing the clothes and you don't throw it away, you know. Then we can see also with jeans, you can, many things you have seen here, you can apply also to your jeans, you know, on you cut your pants and whatever.
You just had a passion for fashion for 30 years.
You've been I'm Austrian, and I came to Florence to study fashion design, and I made the fashion design, and then I specialized in also handbags and teaching now. Therefore, in fashion, I'm in for 30 years, but teaching 15 only.
Fantastic. It's awesome that you can now expand your reach to reach everyone across the globe. That's really cool.
And I never would have tried to do it, but like this, I was forced, because half of the students, they had to go away, and then I had to continue the classes. And in the beginning, I was really, oh my God, how can it be? But in the end, it works. Yes, it's interesting. It's different.
That's awesome.
That is. All right.
Great. Bye. Bye-bye.
Enjoy your night.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
For lunch, you can sit outside. It's nice.
Oh, that sounds
come to Florence. Come to Florence.